Hi, my name is Nick DeSoulis, and I am a hydrologic technician with the main office of the New England Water Science Center. In this screencast, I will discuss how you can perform a more advanced review of data collected in Section by Section Pro when needed. First, let's start with one important point. This advanced review is not something that should be done or needed for most midsection data collected in Section by Section Pro. Proper review during the measurement and at the site once the measurement is complete should eliminate most issues that would need this detailed advanced review. Collecting good quality data will allow you to eliminate most of these issues if they are detected and addressed during data collection. That said, let's take a look at a measurement that has some irregularities. Notice the very slow velocities at the surface in nearly every vertical. The velocity profile plot indicates this data is large magnitude negative velocity, which is likely not realistic. We see in the contour plot that water air velocities are fairly high in some of these bins, but not all. We have the ability to change the error threshold for each vertical, or the up threshold for the entire measurement, but there are no good tabular views in Section by Section Pro to determine reasonable values. Rather than use trial and error, let's load this data into WinRiver II so we can utilize the better data viewing options there. First, open BBSlice, a program that comes as part of RDI tools. For the input file, select the PD0 for the measurement, which is the raw data file. For the output file, I like to use sliced, which will create a file for each vertical named sliced 000, 001, and so on. Click the slice button, and the utility will create a new output file for each vertical and will include unused verticals. In the measurement directory, we now see the new slice data files with the .000 extension. In WinRiver 2, select Create Measurement from Data Files, navigate to the measurement directory, type *.000 in the file name box, and select all of the sliced files. For each vertical, now a transect, you will get a warning box stating there is no associated configuration file. Simply click OK for each. You'll notice in the playback configuration that there are no processing settings, no transducer depth, or other information. It is simply the raw ADCP data. You could enter this information, but we will leave it as is for the purpose of this data review. You will also notice the reference is set to bottom track, which could cause errors if there was a significant bias in the bottom track data, so consider changing the reference to none. Now that the raw data is loaded, you can reprocess each transect, essentially allowing you to review one vertical at a time with access to the tabular and graphical options in WinRiver 2 that are not available in Section by Section Pro. In this measurement, we were seeing negative velocities near the surface that seemed to be erroneous in Section by Section Pro. Bringing up a velocity tabular allows us to see that most of the error velocities near the surface are high. Our water track error threshold in Section by Section Pro was set to 1.969, which is high enough that it really isn't screening much of the invalid data near the surface. Scanning through the velocity tabular in WinRiver 2 for several verticals indicates a value of about 0.5 would remove most of the data near the top with high velocity error values. Back in Section by Section Pro, we note an as-is discharge of about 18.3 CFS for this measurement. We can first go into the processing dialog and set the Good Ensemble to Cell setting to 5, which will force the software to require 5 valid ensembles to compute a bin at each depth in the vertical. Then, we go into each station and manually change the error threshold to 0.5. Be sure to check the profile plot and ensure all of the invalid data is being screened. If you still see erroneous values, decrease the threshold value. And if you feel too much data is being screened, increase it so the erroneous values are removed, but enough valid data remains. Once all of the erroneous data is removed, the final discharge is around 46 CFS and looks much more reasonable in the contour plot and the profile plot, though the indicated angles are inconsistent. You would want to be sure to document in your notes what changes were made and how the values you applied were determined.